Obama, Nielsen and Jürgen Bisch. Following them round is number 15, which is in third position to the line. Is and holding on the line is the Swiss bearing of Uli Brack and Andra. Yeah. Behind them comes number 25, Imbert Zimmermans and Eric Verheigen. Then a little queue of traffic as number 20, Walter Netterscheid and Jürgen Hassel arrive. Followed then by number 16, Michael Garhammer and his new passenger, Dietmar Piquet. Behind them, number 18, Klaus Weinemann and Thomas Weinemann. Then number 5, the World Championship leaders, Christoph and Andreas Susser. Behind them, Dietmar Schmidt and Lotta Gell, number 17. Then the British crew of the Brooks Brothers, number 39. A nice ripple for them as they go to the line. Followed then by number 23, Hugo de Vries and Harry de Bresser. Then number 9, Carl Mavis and T.D. Janssen. Followed then by 37, James Keats. Then Dean and Mike Turner, number 46 behind them. Number 38 behind them, and down goes the gates, and the sidecar Grand Prix of Great Britain is on. Into the corner first, and it looks as if it's a British crew well up there. They've gone wide. It was Ducky Fox, I think, that went wide, but the leader, Tom Van Hooyden and Fritz Kingham. Behind them is number 12, Tom Anderson, the fastest man in time training.
That's really dodgy if they come through here.
Come down the right hand side, switch right over to the left. Place, he becomes world champion whatever Netterscheid does. So, and Netterscheid's passenger can see Husser behind him. He just told his driver as well, and in fact Husser is looking to go past. To go, anything can happen. We've got one rider back into the race that we thought was going out, and that's Doug Fox and Paul Chapman. They're back in with a vengeance and flying round this side, so they're obviously going to race on, looking for odd points and the over the lead. So the Zabel Mako moving into the lead in second place. Then in 27, Tom Van Hooyden and Fritz Kingham, the Mitchell Horser brothers, to be in third place. Fourth in number 16, that's Michael Garhammer, and second behind them in number 25, Timmermans. And then it looks the first British crew in seventh place.
They've got three quarters of the length of the Farley Hill now. Lead
Chapman had just gone down to deliver at the back of the queue, but Nettershy safely through the finish area. The sidecar finished 15-2 and the ruts around the finish area, and the change on the leaderboard again now. Darhammer goes up in second. In the arena, but all eyes are fixed on the yellow and black colours of the German crew, number 20. Walter Nettescheid and Jürgen Hassold. They slip through the loops of this Farley circuit. Passenger having to work hard to stand straight. Turn right, left onto the finish area. Through the finish area with 12 and a half minutes gone, so we're not halfway yet. Sink into the middle of the little two ruts of the four around the bend here, and away they go, but still the fight is on for second place. Darhammer is the second place man, the Hoods have got them in third. Fourth is the third, the fifth is the fourth, number 25, that's Timmermans. Then behind him is Tom Van Hoyten in sixth place. Seventh is Dura, number 31. It looks as if the Brooks brothers may be in ninth position. That battle between Husser and Darhammer runs truly on. They go down the pitch straight. Husser looks to get on Darhammer. He runs the fence down there. Number 39, leader, knocked down the straight there. Chest, wing in from left to right, good. In full control as it's the rise in the bottom. The rise is going to weigh out of that.
Going on round the car in an effort to, or round the bike car in an effort to get back to the race. A request from the car for the course, please, that the area is containing people who shouldn't be there. And a request also that right in the signal us, don't step out of the course. Even if it's in the signal. Husser still challenging for that second place. Darhammer in front of him. Moments before. There's the course again, there's Richard. Being urged on by the crowd on this corner. The first corner past the finish, Red Serge, come on, all the way around the circuit. I think the leader's gone through, then the battle's still here for second, 43, 43 and 5. He's still up there, there's Nick Grace. Is the leader of the behind him. And number 14, Belgian. Couple more wide before we have to. Behind him, number 13. Behind them now, that's Walter Nettescheid,
Jürgen Russell, and then behind them is Neil Lundgren.
Then a gap before number 46, Dan Dean Turner.
Well, I've got the leader back in front of me because the flapping the Jetro Vladimir Fedenko and Malandaska.
Well, the very noisy now. Number 21 goes by me as well, Carl Osler and his brother.
Welcome back to the second half of the meeting and the riders coming to the line now for the second leg of the 11th round of the British Sidecar Cross Grand Prix. Coming up now for the start of the second leg. The winner of the first race, Walter Nettescheid, already in there. Promptly to start at 4 o'clock. This
Jules Mercedes has taken the lead. Nettescheid coming around the outside. He's coming around the outside.
60's Nettershy.
Indeed they are, they're back into the main arena, and the French crew of Gilles Messine and Eric Morgan leading the pack up the hill for the first time. A lot of smiles now down on the start line, so obviously the clerk of the course is happy that the second leg has gone away without incident. But here comes the pack charging down the hill. Gilles Messine leading the pack, but right behind him the Danish pairing of Bomo Nielsen and Jürgen Bitsch. And they are right on the top. Swinging round the tree, down the grandstand straight, into Camel Corner. And Nielsen looking to take that lead. It's a dash for the line here. Nielsen has got it. So Nielsen takes the lead. He's looking at Bitsch. Bitsch working overtime there. Gilles Messine. Three down turns, but Nielsen has pulled away from the Hooker line in fourth place. Then it's the Kawasaki of number 31, Andreas Fuhrer. Behind them is number 16, Michael Garhammer. Behind Garhammer is number 23, who nearly came to a stop there. Hugo de Vries. The Dutch crew badly told their place. Leader away, and it's still Nielsen charging down the pit straight. Messine in second, and all that third man nearly lost his compliment because he was right short side with the intent down the side here. Had to force his body over to the left hand side of the chair then to save, banging his right shoulder all down the fence. The arena. Down the hill comes the leader now, number 12, Bomo Nielsen. And Nielsen with that Zabel Mako beginning to open the gap over the second place, Morgan. Nettershide now up into third place. So Nettershide climbing to make his way up to the bottom of the hill, winning this Grand Prix on an overall basis. Been pushed down the grandstand straight now. Timmermans is the man pushing it. Right on the back of the bike they are now. Behind them is the Hutzler brothers. Behind those number 31, Andreas Fuhrer. Then behind him, number 16, Garhammer. Then number 23, Hugo de Vries. Chris Edwards there. So Chris Edwards is going
between Paul Millard, Doug Fox and Roy Humphreys there. All three of the British boys locked together in battle. So those three are really fighting it out. It's just most likely will pull them up the leaderboard a little bit.
I was just going to say that, Ron, that a battle between them will do them good because it could push them up. Showing the back, a clean pair of heels, and Nettershide now looking for second place. Trying to go round the outside of the French pairing, round the tree. Gilles Messine holds them for a while, but Nettershide is going to slide round the outside here. Brilliant race here. Nettershide takes second place, moves up front. Gilles Messine slips into second place. The French pairing back in third, working overtime. Then the battle behind them. Number 25, Timmermans, is just managing to hold out the Husser brothers. That battle now coming down into the woods.
Yeah, but I've got him here with me, and it's still number 12 here. He's hanging on to his lead, but like you say, the battle there for second spot.
You've got a three-way battle of the Brits coming to you right now.
Yes, we've got him here with us, Dave. Young Brooks in Fox is here, but losing out on him now is Paul Millard. I don't know where he's got trouble. Brooks pulling right away from Millard. So Millard's having a little bit of bad luck, it looks like it to me. He's going past us here, number 9, and going quite steady. They're holding off number 40.
Well, Nettershide has arrived down here now in a... Nettershide opening the gap now between himself and the French crew of Gilles Massen and Eric Morgan. Behind them now is Husser, so Husser has moved up to 4th. In 5th place is Timmerman. 6th place is Führer. 7th place is Garhammer. 8th is number 23, that's Hugo de Vries. Who's just grabbed that 9th place. 10th is Chris Everidge, so Everidge getting pushed back a place there. Everidge charging after Schmidt. He's not giving this one up, so Everidge back behind the handlebars there. Working overtime, his passenger swinging from left to right, hugs him as they go around the right hander. Didn't get into screen though, as Schmidt, another 5, past number 18, Klaus Weinmann slips through, but he's come out of trouble, he's crashed out of control, straight through the pit gate, he didn't mean to go there, and he's back into the track, but it cost him 2 places, and then Andy House and the Brooks brothers battling it out behind them.
Well, we got 6th place man just going by.
He was up there for a long time in the first race, finished 7th in that first race, but not going to be in the same situation with this one. Meanwhile, the leaders are back with us, and Palmo Nielsen slides round the corner, and obviously trying to make it to Denmark 1-2, because Erik Gundersen won the World Speedway Final last night after a runoff with Hans Nielsen, and also from Denmark to old enemies. Together, but deadly enemies when it came to the runoff the Speedway last night. Nielsen trying to emulate the Nielsen in Logan last night. Rather getting the runner-up position today and in with a good chance, I would think. Well, number 12, the leader, Nielsen, has gone through, Dave, and number 20 is flying violently to catch up, takes a different line, nearly turns the chair up a bit. Then behind him, number 5, and he's going wide. Rusty are getting very awkward, it hasn't had to put his driver out, put his foot out there, keep the foot, Mike in the sidecar upright. So these boys that are the champions are going to try, our British boy who takes a totally different line, and didn't go in the ruts at all, so Chris Etheridge there taking a different line and missing the ruts, but most of the corners going straight through the deep ones and causing the chairs to lift rather high in the air. Then we got to number 39, young Brooks there, Richard and Andrew. Both of them taking a different line, it's old Spock, but he's being hard pressed by 2 of the foreign boys there right behind him. Well, Palmo Nielsen is back with us in the arena. The holes, the ruts getting deeper and deeper. In fact, I reckon the solo should be wet. You could get lost. Nielsen nevertheless slides round the corner up behind the start. A nice comfortable lead now at number 42. Vladimir Vaninka and Milan Tasker come through a lap down already. So Czechoslovak sidecar cross has got a long way to go by the looks of it. Nettershide's in 2nd place. 3rd are the Husser brothers, the world champions. 4th is number 15, that's the French crew of Gilles Massine. 5th is number 25. That's Timmermans and Verhagen from Holland. As number 46, Dean Turner and Mike Turner give way then to the Pirelli B has landed, and I understand that some landed up in the woods as well. Is that right?
Yes, I must say a big thank you to Pirelli for that. I will claim the first after this race. Without a doubt, with this Pirelli, I always used to use their tyres, and now seems like they're supplying me with the green as well. Now,
that can't be too bad, but back to the race. The leader goes through. Barnard deals a good lead now from second place man, Walter Netterscheid. Jürgen Hassold in the chair. Comfortable second place. Then the French crew goes through. Schilderstein, Eric Smalton. In fourth place, the Husser brothers. Fifth is number 20.
But he's now managed to climb out. That was number 13. Took a nasty tummy or Timmy Tischenhausen. Number 30 here, but he's climbed back on and the passenger's clinging on, but he's proud of it. I can see the bare leg of him as the leader goes by him. So the leader would be 25 there, still in fifth. Timmerson. Then we got number 23 following him. Turner's book. 31 there in that Maklik green there with the Kawasaki bike, a real
compared with the first one. A good race here with Farmer Nielsen showing a clean pair of heels to the second place man, number 20, Walter Netterscheid. The leaders now beginning to rapidly get in amongst the pack. Gilles Fassin arrives in third place and the Husser brothers are coming up on Fassin quite hard now. And it is only going to be a matter of time, I think, before Hussars start pushing the French crew. Flipping round the corner, up the hill they go. Round the hairpin, past the finish. And Husser is closing on the scene. The scene on the Kawasaki, Husser on the KTM. But the world champion, obviously enjoying this race, all the pressure off him, he can go out and enjoy this race.
Well, the leader's here with me, number 12, then like you say, David. Opening the gap a little bit, but I think behind him is the world champion there, as number 5. Timmerson, following him is 23, here's first. There's a lot more interesting, a lot more scraps going on all the way down. Here's the bright green boy, number 31 with a Kawasaki. Really going, it's been Herbert Hawley. These two are really fighting it out together. And then we got the next of the British boys, number 39. The best of the British boys in the first one, young Brooks there. Young Richard Brooks and Andrew. Then a gap before number 35, another of our English boys, Dougie Fox and Paul Chapman on the Polar DML.
Meanwhile, I've got the leader back here, still Barmar Nielsen going through the check curve, but Enker and Tasman come round the corner here. It looks as if they are coming out of the race. Goes over the hill, in second place. Andy House goes through a lap down on the leaders because Jürgen goes into Husser, is closing on the scene in fourth position all the time. That little battle going on as number 45, Colin Philpott and Nick Grace go through a lap down on the leaders. They are sliding down the right hand side, giving the main front chance to get alongside and pass them.
Well, the leaders number 5. Then the next man through into the line is 25, Timmerson. Behind them is number 23, who's just gone past the 40. There's the Kawasaki boy, number 31. And the Switzerland boy. Right behind them is 17, Timmerson. On the EML, followed then by number 32, Herbert Hurley, his brother Hansen Hurley, came on the EML.